Pastor Julie from St. Stephen, and I'm here to share with you today a thought about how we can face this time of social distancing. Throughout the history of the church, we have a long tradition of withdrawing, having retreats, pulling back from the world, and taking time to meditate on the Word of God, to commune with each other, to have prayer time and quiet time, and just to focus on God and what's really important in our lives. None of us really planned that this would be a time we'd be doing this, but since we've been given this opportunity, let's take advantage of it. I've had people ask me, Pastor, do you have good ideas for devotions or daily devotions or a daily reading schedule of the Bible? There are all kinds of them. If you want to go online and Google daily Bible readings, you can find many. But I'm going to offer a suggestion from the Green Book, the Lutheran Book of Worship. In the front of it, on page 178, there is a page entitled Psalms for Daily Prayer. And it's simply that, psalms that we can use to pray during this time of retreat and contemplation. I've also had people ask me, Pastor, how do you use the Psalms for prayer? There's a variety of ways. Differs depending on if you are alone or if you are with other people. But in any case, it's simply reading them and thinking about them in a contemplative way. So if you're alone, you can read out loud or you can read quietly. If you are with other people, you can read responsively. One person reading one verse, another person reading another verse. Or you can read in unison, all reading together. However it is, I recommend that you read very slowly, that you pause between verses, that you think to let the words really soak in. You might want to repeat the psalm more than once, depending on how long it is. And then afterwards, sit with it for a few minutes, think about it. And if you're alone, maybe in writing, or if you're together, you can talk about what comes to mind. Are there words or images that jump out? Are there memories of God's faithfulness in previous times that are brought up by these psalms? In any case, the psalms are a wonderful treasure house of prayer and praise and crying out to God that has been given to us, and this would be a great time for us to practice using it. Thanks for listening.